Hello?
Hello. Hi, Kinkad. How are you today?
Well, I guess I have a better day than you have.
Oh, you sure do. You sure do. I had a pretty interesting day. Oh boy. I guess it happened. Well, apparently, I bought three very expensive cameras, an RTX 2080 Ti, a 4K monitor, and a 12 terabyte NAS hard drive for about
What the fuck?
$4,000, all going to Ontario.
Yeah.
Apparently, that's what I bought. Apparently. Oh man. Yeah, so I'm out of my credit card. I'll get a new one within a week or so. I mean, that's how long it takes for them to send me a new one. Until then,
Yeah.
I have to rely
So
on my debit.
you wanted to buy the stuff, and then it turned out your pr credit card doesn't cover anymore for the cost, and that's why you found out that you
No,
got frauded, or
not really. I check pretty much every other week because I pay my credit card every, let's say, 10 days. I like to pay it off, whatever I use. I made a payment of $3,000 just last week. And then I just found out today that I owe them about $4,000 more. Like the outstanding balance is still 4,300. And I was like, what in the world did I buy? Like, I know I didn't buy that, and I just went up Amazon, 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 and I'm like, there are eight Amazon orders, and I'm like, what the hell? And I log into my Amazon orders, and there's nothing there. I mean, the last thing I bought was a t-shirt like last month, and I'm like, what the hell? So I called Amazon, and they're like, no, you bought this, 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 and I'm like, okay, if I bought this, 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 why is it not in my orders? And they're like, oh, okay, that's interesting. I said, no shit, you tell me where that came from. They're like, you bought a camera, another camera, and okay, they found like they in like immediately realized this is obviously absurd. And then I called my bank, they blocked my card immediately, and hopefully this matter gets resolved very quickly. Otherwise, I'm gonna have a few sleepless nights. Yeah.
All right. So is Casey Irion casting with us?
He joined a second, but I think he couldn't talk or hear us, so I think he's gonna rejoin. We'll
Yeah,
ask him.
so but he's casting.
I think so. I think he should be here any minute.
Yeah. So how does this work? Is this
Hello.
now
Oh, here he
Hello?
is. Hi.
Hello.
Awesome. Yes, we can hear you.
I may have time for a game or two, I hope so.
All right, I'll tell D3rp to make this quick if that
Yeah. So is this now a best of five? And if Derp wins, it's over. And if Dark wins, it's another best of three? Or how does it work?
Well, it's best of five, so if whoever wins the first three games, it's still over.
Really? Is there no advantage for the guy who is still in the winner's bracket?
No, this is the final of the final of the final, so there is nothing else left. So it's best of five, right? Just like the last games we had from
Yeah, sure, but
semifinals. So.
usually it's that way that in a winners or loser bracket match, that the guy who's still in the winners bracket, who hasn't lost a series in a tournament, gets some kind of advantage, like being up 1-0 in a best of five or best of seven, like having a map one map advantage. Or they play out the best of five now, and if the guy from the lower bracket wins, then they play another series of a best of three or something. But yeah,
Really? No,
if
I did
you
not
didn't do
know about
that,
that.
you cannot change the rules now on the
No,
last
it's
meter.
gonna be standard, so it's just simple. It's whoever wins the most out of five games, I guess that's how we do it, right? So whoever wins the most. I mean,
Yeah,
two.
so let's hope Job just wins, then we don't have to discuss this.
Trust me, I'm having a rough day as well, you know that. So I also wanna make some phone calls. Anyways, well, we'll get right into it, and I'll let the players know they can obviously start, and I think they can do their map pool right now. Okay. All good. You can start your civ pick. All right, Casey, welcome. Sorry, we had a little other discussion going on before you joined. Sorry about
Oh, no
that.
problem.
All right, and they started their draft. Here we go.
Can you send me the link?
Yes, I
I
will.
wasn't in the room yet, I
I
guess.
will do that too.
Are you live already, by
yes,
the way?
Yes, I am. Oh, shoot, I was. Everybody heard it then.
And I guess you should update the title at least. It's not Dark Against Steve Rogers anymore.
I will do so. Thank you for that. All right, go ahead. You guys are more than welcome to talk about the civs over there that they are picking.
Or banning in that case. Teutons and Aztecs makes total sense to ban.
Yeah, the question now probably is if you want to ban out two OP civs or just ban out some bullshit like Vietnamese and split the OP civs between each other.
Yeah, but Malai going out makes sense as well. I expect this. I don't know about the last civ to ban, but Aztecs and Malay definitely.
Yeah, so definitely going the route of banning all the strong civs. So we might see some matchups we haven't seen in the tournament yet.
And no Slavs. Interesting. I like it.
I hope we get to see something really odd, like Persians or Huns, which we didn't see a single time in this whole tournament.
Well, I guess it would be the bottom of the ladder. But yeah, Celts are being first picked by Dark the Late, who's... Yeah. Ah yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, the other guy's definitely a derp whenever he's bashing Aquino, that's for sure. Who it is. Oh, Spanish, alright.
Yeah, Spanish is good. Question is, do we see Mayans here? Are we going to see... the Turks, probably not. But the Vikings, wow.
Wow.
That's going to be fun.
Well, I hope we see a lot of Berserks then. I don't want to see Arbalest and just GG and do kills. That's not what I want to see.
Yeah, but in best of five, it's always tricky to get the matchup you desire because there are so many options for both players. And I guess you just want to pick like civilizations who are strong in general. So you don't get bad luck with your matchup.
Brits, all right.
That isn't Dark a trash player? Shouldn't he go for like Incas and Koreans here just for the lulz?
I really think so, and I don't want to see a trash. Honestly, I hate his two tower bullshit trash. It's just so annoying, and he does this in team games. He does this in team games, and it costs the whole team the game because the pocket comes and bashes him, and our pocket can't help him. You know what I mean? So
yeah,
tell him, don't do this, man. What the hell? Oh my god. Oh, Byzantine. All right. So that's probably monks over there. Mayans. Interesting.
Yeah. Ethiopian sticks out to my eye. I think we haven't seen them too often in this tournament yet.
Yeah, now I'm confused who is Dark because the other civs look like definitely Dark Civ for trushing, but this is so odd.
Well, he doesn't have a problem with rushing with other civs. Like, he doesn't need the best tower rush civs for his tower rush. He will just suit regardless.
Brits are very good for trushing because for him, even when he does his two tower bullshit, he can easily add the TCs because of cheaper TCs, right? Oh, there we go. Inca. There we go.
Yeah, Turks coming up. Makes sense. Now
Burmese.
Wow. Okay, are we going to see a monk rush finally?
Please. I want to see something different than a trush.
Saracens. I wished for Koreans now, but no, not happening.
Oh boy.
Yeah, but Aquino, no, not Aquino. D3rp definitely has some good Monk Rush civs like Byzantines, Spanish, and Burmese can definitely go for it. Byzantines and Burmese more than Spanish, obviously. But yeah, this will be a strategy deployed most likely in this series.
All right, this is very interesting. I will take a snippet of these civs and upload it.
Only civ I'm really missing here kinda is Malians, maybe. Could have been an option, but we see Ethiopians. And not sure, but people liked Franks lately before it went to DE, so that's also so we could have seen. Chinese, not sure about that. But okay, yeah. And I'm pretty sure Spanish and Celts will be used here. Not sure about Ethiopians, actually, but I hope so. Saracens could be interesting as well. I think you can go for a really nice thrush there. But for the first game, I hope we're not seeing the best or the worst diffs out of these.
Yeah, I heard in the semifinal, Dark actually trushed in every game, so except one game, and he lost that one. So I'm very curious how he will play in this final now.
I would want to see anything but trush. I really, really think that would be so annoying. And the worst part is he gets away with, but I think D3rp is pretty good in, you know, not overreacting to, you know, the stuff that he has done with other players. So this may be different, but we'll have to really, really see. But I can assure you one thing. Dark has been practicing with Dench a lot for this tournament. Like, even the last time he played with Steve Rogers, Ivanka, he was practicing nonstop. And I know in the inside because Dench told me that, yeah, no, he practiced really well. And right now, even for, I think, this match, he practiced as well. And I don't know if D3rp has been doing the same. So let's see if our young player over here can do this again.
Well, about the trash, the thing is, D3rp played quite a lot of games against Terra. And we all know Terra is a trash player on Arena. Can you find this out? Durban 1v1, most frequent opponents, John Slow, 67 games, only won 15, lost 52, and I guess John Slow, like, trashed in half of those games.
Oh, boy.
So maybe he knows his way around defending a trash, and we could see interesting game, despite the fact that trash is obviously possible and expected. Now we're waiting for them to start. I guess they're really thinking hard about the sifs now.
Yeah, I think they're just waiting in the lobby, just trying to figure out what to do.
Sheet looks all right here.
Oh boy. I think Saracen is the only one who got picked by Dark twice. He did this the other time. He had a very strange build. Or I don't know if you were... I think you were there or not. I'm not sure, Casey. But he used the market and he did some real crazy stuff with it and was able to make it work with this trash, I think.
I feel the market is kind of underrated on Arena. The Saracens can do really strong stuff, I guess. Yes. But it's tough to figure it out. And oh, we're starting soon, 20 seconds back delay. So now this is getting interesting. What's the first civilizations here? Are they going to have picked? I expect Britons for Dark now in the first game.
We are there. All right, I'll quickly introduce the players. So red, we have D3rp, and in green, we have Saracens as Dark. Oh boy, all right, Casey, I'll let you introduce D3rp's map, followed by KingCat.
And D3rp is really close to the middle of the map, a very wide arena, long walls here, can easily be attacked. So if Dark has a good trash build order, an aggressive build order for the Saracens, I think he should go for it. But the map, not too bad, as we see in the back here, main stone safe in the back, second and third gold safe in the back, and two extra goals. This is awesome. So even if he's getting trashed here, D3rp should be able to fall back on a lot of resources and then should be able to survive, usually at least. Main gold kind of forwardish. The second stone is outside to the top of his base. Another really close to him, also close to the stone here. Three deer outside on the corner. That's something not too nice. It's not easy to lure them in and it's pretty far away. Can we play standard arena next time? Ooh, interesting. What is Dark asking here?
They actually did use the standard arena, but they didn't use my version of arena, which would have a little bit more deer. Remember, like four tiles closer. So the four tile closer would actually, if you see even right now, would put the deer inside his walls. And that's what they were trying to get over there.
And only now Dark is realizing. else on the map, another relic to the bottom of the map or close to the other corner for D3rp, and an extra stone also close to him, so all the extra resources actually on his side of the map. Could be interesting to see how Dark is going to react. Let's see his map, but it's not my job here. Go ahead, please.
Yep. So Dark's map is basically the complete opposite, you can say. The only safe thing about his base is his main gold, which is far in the back. But apart from that, all his resources are very exposed. The two additional golds are on the outside. One stone is on the outside, and one stone very close to the walls on the inside. But D3rp should be able to see it already in Fuel Age with his scout. So, yeah, not really the best maps. The best map, the resources are exposed. But it doesn't really matter if Dark actually wants to go forward anyways with towers, so... That would be a way for him to secure his map.
Guys, one big thing. I don't know if the spectator overlay is telling me correctly, but do you see a dead body under Dark's TC?
I actually heard the sound of a villager or something dying.
Yep, and there's one pop behind, but even though the deaths are zero, I think that may just be a bug. What do you think? I mean, I do see a dead body right there, and there's a villager difference already, so I think he lost a... quite big, and he's doing loom. Oh man, this is a rough start for Dark here.
Oh wow. Yeah, I was hearing the sound, then I also checked the KD and it was still 0-0, so I thought it was just a random sound bug or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, something bad happened in the early game. And we actually have a scout fight.
Yep.
Okay, who's the host?
That matters?
It could matter.
I think Red will win.
No idea when.
Oh, wow.
Dark one. Okay, this changes a lot in this game.
And the lag is there. I'm pretty sure it's because D3rp just said this lag, and I'm pretty sure there's a lot. And the worst part is D3rp didn't actually scout his last goal, but I think he still saw the other two, so I think he should be fine. Oh boy. What do you think about all this, KC? I mean, a lot of things escalated at this game already.
Well, I'm wondering, Dark, but it's not going in with that scout, and the villager will be in time to close this piece of the wall. Would have loved to, Dark sending three villagers immediately, build a barracks, go for a rush here. That would have been fun. But as D3rp lost the scout, but D3rp, I think, is very secure at this point and with a bad start. 15 or now 16 to 18 villagers, but it's almost 2.5 villagers behind. D3rp will have a really tough time here. Yeah, lag even for the spectators, I feel, right? It's not fluently.
Absolutely. I feel that as well. And it's quite... we know D3rp lags like crazy. It's just the way he's always lagging. I don't think that he can help himself. I have no idea what's the real issue.
D3rp's board not really good, but he's in time for the next house. That was quite close, actually. I'm a little surprised that he destroyed or deleted its straggler tree next to his TC, because he can use some good wood from that. But okay, and he's pushing the three deer that are inside his base, technically, towards the TC now. That's very good for him. Looks like he's not going for an early trush here. It's not the build order any longer for a standard trush.
Yeah, you would think so, but him getting loom early is, for me, it would be a sign of trushing anyways, because if you trush, you want to get the loom, and if you don't want to trush, you may as well just don't get loom, save the resources, and get the next villager produce a little bit earlier. So I would bet he would still rush, but he can't click up just now because he got so delayed in his early field age, but he could go forward still.
And there's three villagers going to stone, so we are going to see the trush anyways. And yeah, I think it's a good option for him here. Maybe the only one.
Oh, but I don't like this messy start, because this is just so... I mean, imperfect from both players. He lost his scout while the other guy lost a villager. And there comes your goddamn trash. I'm so sorry, I'm a little bit on the edge today, but I am gonna see a trash again, won't I?
Expected.
Yeah, but this will be quite a different version of the Trush from Dark. Like, usually he mines 50 stone in order to be able to build two towers at the enemy base, and then he transitions into a more economy-focused game. Now he already built a mining camp that's really heavy on stone with 6 villagers, so we will either see a lot of towers, or he will sell a lot of stone and get an insane uptime out of this. So, we shall see.
Yeah, I'd expect the second version. I don't think we're going to see more than like 3 towers early on, maybe even only 2. And he might not even need a lot of towers, as he's, of course, going towards that corner where the house is, and that's really a weak point for D3rp. Then again, D3rp will be up to feudal age before Dark is actually going to be able to go inside. And that's why I think both players will be able to go to castle age quite fast here. Even though Dark is going for the Trush, but 22 villagers, it's not too many, but it's not bad either. And the Saracen's Market bonus should be really good for him. Mm-hmm. Now the villagers actually not going towards the house here. What's the plan now? The tower coming up, a decent position, I guess. And Dark did not dare to go in. He's not going for that second stone, but he cannot see the main stone, so maybe he thought it doesn't really matter. And Feudal Age coming in for D3rp as well. Is he going to wall a little bit? It's a question for me now. Or are we going to see a counter tower? And then that wall is coming up.
The wall. Huge wall right there. Okay. I actually don't like that he's gonna break into that corner, because, you know, it's a very small area where it could be easily walled off. I think it's always nicer to go in a wider place so you can go at least one or the other direction. But let's see how this turns out.
Yeah, I don't know. On the other hand, the house will go down a lot faster than a stone wall would, so...
Yeah,
at least he will get a little bit of access faster, but yeah. He will definitely need to place another tower to get progress.
Ooh, Dark has very good resources and he's clicking up to castle age already.
Wow.
Look at this. That's beautiful.
What the hell? What just happened?
Market!
Yeah, he sold the stone, obviously.
Yes, oh. I wasn't joking when I said this guy has been practicing these odd stuff with Dench, and who knew this is gonna happen.
And I guess this may force D3rp to actually put up a counter tower, as the 3 villagers moving in and the palisade walls are still very, very weak. So D3rp, I think, should place the tower already, which he's not doing. Probably wants to have enough stone for a castle in early castle age.
Oh,
4 villagers on stone only. And he's missing some food here, so he may even need to use the market himself. Not sure how the prices for him are. Food 143. Yeah, that's tough. So D3rp investing into more villagers.
What just happened here? He just bailed out on the tower and now he's gonna build it?
Well, Dark actually knows that if D3rp commits on building the tower, his tower will be faster, so he just doesn't bother.
And this is such a mind game right now. He's forcing one tower, building the other one. This is so... crazy from these guys.
But what is the next step now for D3rp? He's going for the towers, but I'm pretty sure D3rp will be able to guard his main gold using a castle. And then it's going to be tough for D3rp, as he's not really in a position to go like castle and fast imp. And not sure if the monks, they are possible, of course, but is it going to be good enough? Doubt it a little bit. And there's only 2 villagers on the main gold for D3rp. I guess he's sending more. Castle Age coming up. What's going to happen here? Siege Workshop, okay?
Okay. I think D3rp would be so surprised that what the hell, how is he already Castle Age at this point? You know? That's probably a big shock.
Yeah, but I wonder how this will turn out, because obviously he can get a Mangonel Monastery now, but D3rp already has access to a castle very soon, so he can just surrender his main gold, fall back to a gold, one of his golds in the back, and he could be fine if he manages to place a good castle and cover a lot of his space. The problem is there's a lot of space to cover on this map.
This is a full smush incoming, I'm guessing, but maybe I think D3rp needs a bit more on gold over there, or maybe is he planning to sell stone all day? Could be an option.
Yeah, it's probably a result of the very bad Dark Age. He's lacking like two villagers for this, and two villagers more on wood, he would be able to make a Mangonel already. He started it now, but he could have started it way earlier. So,
ooh, what do you guys think about that castle placement? I'm not too happy on that castle placement. What do you think, Casey? And
I guess it's all right, as D3rp realizes, okay, Dark is only attacking from the right-hand side. It's going to be really tough for him to go all around, and by the time he is going to be able to do it and like go on the left-hand side, on the far side, there will be Janissaries on the field to defend. So it's not really entirely covering the main gold, but it's in a position that he's not getting attacked by the Mangonel. We might see one shot, but that's it. And can Dark see the castle? Yes, he can see it. So I think it's all right here at this point in the game. And D3rp obviously didn't want to give up on the main gold entirely. So the question is for Dark now, how to proceed here? And he's not looking good on the resources, obviously. Going for a second TC on the wood line is Dark, where the deer, the last deer is. I guess it makes sense to go for the free food here. But going TCs could be interesting, could be fatal, actually. Also question, is D3rp going for more extra TCs somewhere? For now, he's lacking the wood, obviously.
Well, let's have a quick farm count, shall we? So, a few number of farms around the TC of D3rp. Let's quickly check, Dark's. Am I blind? Or I just don't see anything.
Plot twist.
Well, new meta, I think, who was it? Eddie would be very proud of D3rp right now.
Yeah, food will definitely be an issue, especially with 2TC. But yeah, maybe he will just manage to sell resources all day and buy food.
Why do I have a feeling there will be a idle TC? Oh, he bought it right there.
Okay, let's just turn this moving out to the middle of the map here. Relics are in range for D3rp here. Can he see? Oh no, not too good of a scouting for D3rp, obviously, as he did lose the scout early on. So he can't really see a lot of relics except for one, and he's not going to be able to get that one easily. Watchtower for D3rp is going down, but no relics for Dark either. And where's the monks for him? Does he have monks on the field? My blind here?
There's one in this space. He also brought a relic with him. And he's building a second monastery in his base. And at least secure one relic this way.
Well, we have a farm now. No, two farms actually for Dark here. And he's still taking berries. 30C up on the outside on that second gold. Interesting decision, but I guess he wants to stay aggressive and hopes that he's gonna be map control long enough to make this work out. Now D3rp is sending the monk to the bottom of the map to find some relics. He should find them very soon. And D3rp, I think, in a very decent position here. Janissaries is doing some damage, and Mangonel went down. Oh, I didn't even see that. But D3rp is not in trouble, not yet at least, but could be very soon.
What I really like is those two Janissaries on top are actually killing the tower. That's just quite weird. 8 range versus 8 range, and guess what? The tower is shooting the blacksmith.
Gotta love this game.
Yes, exactly.
Looks like a mistake from Dark.
But yeah. And we have a monk trying to convert a Genesri, but it could get close. And that Genesri is turning to green. So now D3rp might lose his monk. He's sending more Genesris here, but there's an interesting battle going on as the main battle is not happening.
Converted right back. Look at that.
Ooh, nice.
And he's getting away with the relic.
That is micro nerd confirmed right over there.
D3rp also found the extra stone and the other really close to his base, and if he's lucky, he's gonna find the TC here, and I think he's heading right that way. So that's not too safe anymore. TC probably wasn't the best idea for D3rp. And there we go, the first bullet's shooting, and that's idle TC, or idle villagers in the TC here. In the front, nothing happening, so Siege Workshop and Monastery really doing nothing, and the question is D3rp.
There are two P-Tarts on the way in the middle of the map now, and he will break in very soon into Dark Space.
And I think he should send villagers already, because he's about to have the stone con for his second castle. So he's not going to go for any extra TCs, which makes sense. And the siege workshop maybe not even needed. Petted archer armor also on the way, making the Chinese wrist a little bit stronger. And now Dark is adding archers, going for crossbowmen here. Be interesting. I guess he can't really afford to spend a lot of food on skirmishers. But still, Chinese wrist should be better here. And as the petard's going in, as the bridge of the siege workshop also coming up. Okay, let's see what Derp can do here.
Oh, this is problematic in my opinion. I mean, what will stop Derp from putting a castle like 8-7 tiles away from his main TC or in the middle of his base? I don't think so. Anything stops him. Few skirms won't do it, I think. Especially he has padded archer armor, if you look at the stats on those Janissaries.
Yeah, I would think he would drop the castle right in front of the TC, which would cover like all the stones, this one gold, deny the TC, and it would be very, very tough to clear that out, even if he got to Imperial Age, Dark Pet is, because he has no access to a castle and traps. But yeah, Derp definitely not adding any TCs, so he wants to finish this game really fast.
Yeah, I don't think so. He needs CCs. I mean, he's doing the damage, one killing one villager at a time, so, you know, why would you need to add TCs when you're doing the damage pretty good? And I think he's gonna add the castle soon. He should. I don't know what he's waiting for, though.
It's too bad John Slow isn't here. In the back of Dark Space, there's a lot of mills coming up here, and John Slow is one who's going for three rows before building another mill.
Oh boy, that's true.
And a castle coming up on that outside TC. Pretty much the place you already described. Double Mangonel on the way as well. Yeah, I think Derp might even start to enjoy this game, as he should be very assured of this victory. Don't see a way for Dark to really come back. He's gonna lose the TC of the villagers. I don't see a way to defend this. And then he's gonna be behind in an economy even. He's got three TCs against one, but it's not gonna make a big difference here. Where's the villagers
so
from?
Those are a decent number of archers with Botkin finally, but then we have how many mangoes from Dark? Three on the way, so yeah. We know how that fight is gonna go.
Yeah, he also has a monk or two monks in front, so if he wanted to, he could heal up his Janissaries a little bit, and there would be no issues to take a fight.
Because even with Botkin, we're doing 7 versus 8 range, and I think this is no way. Archers do not beat Janissaries in Castle Age. Only in Imperial Age they will do a good amount. Unless the micro is like that. Okay, let's see. Okay.
Ooh, what is Dark doing? Counter tower! Oh, this is not gonna work out.
Yikes.
Not like this.
Tower might even go down. If Mangonel is hitting it, it's going down 24 HP only. The first one have to go back now, and the castle is definitely going up. And all the villagers are running to the safety of Dark Space here. Yeah, very nice game here from Derp to start the series.
He's even stabbing the TC with the villager. Real boss move.
Yeah, punch the TC, why not, man? That's the new meta, I guess. Okay,
yeah.
Imperial Age coming.
Yep. Yeah, Derp just clicked up to Imperial Age, and that will definitely seal the deal once he gets Bombard Cannons out, or traps.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm pretty doubtful he will manage to hold his main DC until Dark that is, until Derp hits Imperial Age.
Dark is very close to up. He could pick a very good fight and maybe just buy him time, but those 4 mangoes are not gonna allow that. Or 5 mangoes, if I am correct now. That is gonna be difficult. A stable coming up.
Military count is terrible for Dark here, 32 against 14. And Pyrolage halfway done. And we might even see castle number 3 coming up for D3rp really soon, as he's put like 9 villages on Darkstone here. Genesis now can hit some villages.
He's attacking from both sides simultaneously. This is quite micro-intensive, and he's doing a good job, I think, doing that.
You might see the GG actually once D3rp hits Imp. Would make sense because Stark is really, really not looking good here. I don't see a way to defend this. Ooh, nice shot on the cross command as well with the Mangonel.
And while we're talking, the other side, he cleaned up the buildings over there as well, so less production for D3rp.
There's one knight hitting the Mangonel. It's not gonna be enough. Knight going down, crossbowman going down. D3rp clicked up to Imperial Age. But yeah, with one military unit, and I'm not even sure what that one is, this is pretty much over now.
Mm-hmm. And there comes the villagers, as you said. There's your second castle, AC. Right there in his face.
He's not gonna get that up because D3rp is gonna GG out here, I'm pretty sure.
100%. And GG. Well
we
casted there. Well predicted.
Very nice first game here.
Alright, 1-0. Let me update that quick.
Yeah, I'm a little bit sad that D3rp had such a disaster of a Dark Age where he deleted his own villager, then he had to get loot, so it basically was 2 villagers behind, and thus his build didn't have the steam and power to get to its full potential, so there was basically nothing he could have done in this game. I wonder how this build would have went, or if he could have put a lot more pressure if he had this 2 more villagers.
Right.
I'm sad that we didn't see that now.
The other way it hurts too as well, right? Because D3rp lost his scout, so he couldn't lure deer. I don't know which is... Well, I think being behind villagers is still worse, right?
Yeah, especially too, like, one villager for 3 deer, I guess you can make an argument for it being somewhat equal for a time.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, 2 is definitely too much.
Alright, let's see, what civs do we still have? A lot of civs, but we definitely know Turks and Saracens are out. What do we think we can see in the next?
I guess you know D3rp, so tell me, what is the strongest civ left out of the 5?
Britons. He would probably go with Britons.
I expect the Britons. Sorry, I'm going to beg in a minute.
Sure, absolutely. And the reason I say Britons, Kinkat, is, you know, he loves to put those extra TCs right away, and Britons is probably the easiest thing you can do. Incas aren't bad as well, if you want to do Eagle Rush follow, and Mongols are pretty insane for fast trash, but I would bank my money on Britons. What do you think, Kinkat?
Yeah, I guess it will be either of the 3, like Britons, Mongols, or Incas. I think after such a game, you just want to pick a strong civ, get your execute a clean trash, and get back your confidence after this horrendous first game.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
I there are a few steps you don't want to trust. There's like Turks and Turks and Spanish, simply because, or even Burmese in that case, because they have such a hard push right when they, if they're able to get that castle, they will do so much damage to you. Even though D3rp went up faster than him, those Janissaries are just insane to counter, man. Like, what are archers are not gonna cut it. Alright, we're in the game, and... Oh boy, look what we have here. Britons versus Burmese, right over there. And, Kinkat, I'll let you quickly describe D3rp's map. Go ahead.
Alright, so... D3rp's map, well... His stones are a little bit exposed, which D3rp would obviously like if he manages to trash this location. One stone's on the outside and main stone on the inside, but kind of close to the walls. But D3rp won't be able to see that in Dark Age just yet. Mm-hmm. Maybe in Fuel Age, but let's see if the range is big enough. The main gold is also a little bit exposed on the right side of the map towards the walls, but not too far actually, so could be fine. There's one secondary gold in the back, and also one secondary gold, also very close to a 3-tile gold on the outside, on the right side. Mm-hmm. Yeah, little bit of a back base, So this map is it's fine, it's playable.
All right, let's talk about Darek. As I said, he loves his Britons. I just think that's exactly what he would have done, and it turns out he did. And his map isn't the best at all. He does have a back stone, but it's still very close to his wall. He has a back stone also very close to his wall, which is could be harassed. We have a scout fight again, and
yeah, I was just about to say they are rolling the dice again. Let's see how comes out of
win,
this game.
I think, shouldn't he?
Actually, Darek was the first to attack, but looks like D3rp turned around at the right time, and is winning this one. Lucky D3rp here.
And Casey, as I said, Britons for Darek. He loves that 2TC instant 2TC.
Nice prediction.
Same as your castle prediction in the last game. It's right in his face.
It's actually a good matchup for D3rp here, because I'm not sure what Burmese can really do against Britons. It could be tough if it's going to like a phase where in early imp you have the longbow man. So I'm really interested to see how D3rp is going to react to this, what his plan is now.
And we are kind of already assuming this is a trash game, right?
we're just assuming it
automatically. I know he has four on wood, but I wouldn't be surprised if he does the same exact thing as always.
Yeah, but can you really justify it? You cannot scout now. You also weren't able to push a deer, which very much helps out your trash build. I mean, it's like a gamble. He doesn't even know where to go on the map. I mean, I could definitely see him do it, but he just shouldn't do it.
Yeah.
Also, I don't know what you guys think about the matchup, but I think Britain should be heavily favored.
Yeah,
so
heavily favored, absolutely.
You shouldn't have a problem with just playing a macro game, place your 3 TCs early, and try to win the longer game.
What do you think about this, Casey? Have you had chance to have this matchup before, by any chance?
I'm pretty sure I've seen it before, but I don't really remember. And obviously I didn't play it, as I play pretty much never. But in my experience lately, Burmese, so lately, like after last patches, I'm not sure when they were, Burmese really struggle against arborless civilizations. And Britons is like the 200% variation of the longbowmen. So I'm not even sure what's the better choice here, to be honest. We might not even see Longbowmen, but instead we could see like trebuchets with Warwolf, obviously, if needed, and quick Arbalest, so with the Britain's Boom. That could be dangerous for D3rp. And then again, I don't know what D3rp is planning to do here, because a Monk Rush against Britons, probably not. I would love to see Arambai, really, but I haven't seen Burmese Arambai for a very long time. I guess they got nerfed a little bit too hard, maybe. Not sure about it. So the Burmese is a civilization that is hard to master, I guess.
Absolutely. The reason Arambai were so nice before is simply because of their cost. They were so much cheaper. I think they were like 55 wood, if I'm not wrong, Kinkia? And now they are like 80?
Have no idea. I'm sorry. How much they cost before. No, I'm not Chris.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we were missing Chris over here. Let me just quickly check Burmese. They cost... Somebody maybe in the Twitch can tell us. And now they cost 80 wood, yes. And before they were, I think, 55 or 65 at most for a unit. So they really got heavily overpriced to be justified. In...
I guess if it's well played, maybe not against Britons, but I would love to see like a castle, siege workshop, and monastery go for like one or two mangonels, go for Arambai, add a monk or two, and then try to go really aggressive on one TC. Against the Britons, it might not work against the Longbowmen, but against a lot of other civilizations, I would love to see this. And I think it's a pretty, pretty strong combination in Castle Age. But you need to really know what you're doing, and you need to know your build orders. So I haven't really seen it in action, and I wish like somebody like Eddie would be there to try and test this.
Lord.
But I guess we will see Eddie, I hope, or I am expecting to see at NHC3. But on like Age of Empires 2 playing, probably not. What about their build orders? Derp clicking up on 24 villagers. So I guess 3 TC booming here. Monastery probably to get some relics if possible.
Right.
What is Stark doing? It's not a trash, I guess.
Surprise me right now, no trash. He is going on stone though. If you see.
So 3 TC is a castle then, and try to go to a relatively fast imp. I think that's a good advice for Dark here. And I hope that's what he's planning to do. He's going for one more villager, and it's going to be 26 plus 2. That's a really nice idea to go for. Not even going for more, so... No, there it is. Village coming up for him too. 26 plus 2 should be fine here.
Absolutely.
What about the relics, actually? They're too close to Derp, and too close to Dark, and I guess on the right-hand side, more or less in a neutral zone. But I'm not even sure. Are we going to see a fight for the relics here?
That would be
not really, because Dark lost the scout, so he doesn't even know about any of the relics, I think. Or maybe he's seen one. Mm-hmm. Check.
Exactly.
He also won at the top, but yeah, he can't compete because there's still the scout out, so the Burmese player should have a free pass to the relics. Would definitely like to see one fast monastery and start collecting all of these. But yeah, apart from that, I'm expecting TCs from both players at the start.
Not sure if Dark... can allow himself to not go for a castle early on. He definitely wants to go for TCs, or he definitely should go for TCs, but he doesn't know anything about the map, and he could get surprised as well. He's going to allow Derp to go for 5 relics without any resistance, and I think that's not a good idea in Arena. So I'm really wondering if he's going for the early castle or the delayed castle here and go for TCs first. Going to find out very soon. For now, both players up to field age. Dark almost, but there it is. And Derp should click up already. Is that true? Market up, blacksmith up. And missing 2 food. Yeah.
98, that's always disrespectful.
Feels bad, man.
Yes. The 49 number is the most terrible number you can ever experience in your life. Like, you see 49, you know you're screwed. And then it's just 1 food remaining. Oh boy. Alrighty, so that's a smush almost, or something towards that, I'm guessing. That's a good amount of villagers. And we have enough stone, actually not enough stone for our castle, because he has only 4 on stone, so he's gonna probably put TCs, as you said, and maybe castle a little bit later.
Did Dark just do it? Did he sell a stone or buy stone? Wait, or sell wood, buy wood? Who sold wood here? Wait, buy 127. Interesting. Did he buy some food to click up?
I didn't check, really.
Yeah, he must have.
And now I think he is going to build the castle early on, and I think it's a good idea here. But Derp obviously going to be faster, and... Yeah, one monastery at least. Siege Workshop, probably a lot of wood in the bank for him. That's a really nice build. Only question is, when is he going to place the TCs? Like, immediately 3 TCs, or go for Siege Workshop and Monastery first? And he's still scouting the map. He's still looking for Dark's villagers to go forward or anything. He's not going to find too many of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I also have another question. Where do you even want to place your castle if you're Dark? Like, your map is 270 degrees open or something like that. And you can decide to protect your main gold, but then all the other side of the map is open. You can build it at the front, but then Derp can go around to the left or the right. So I think there are no good choices here, really.
Front corner is what I would prefer, as it's closer to Derp, and that's the point where he wants to attack. And I think the far side, you could actually wall it off if you need. There's a nice little wood perch close to the 3DR wall, really far outside. And then you might be quite safe here, even securing one of the golds and the relic. I guess it's not going to happen here, but it's possible. And the castle, where do you want to put it, Dark? Show us your intentions. Ooh, going quite defensive here, just protecting the main gold. Interesting choice.
We have a question also, from the V... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Also, interesting, talking about interesting choices, we have 2 Siege Workshops coming up by Derp, which I didn't quite expect. What's going on here?
That's true.
And Scorpion production starting, yeah, very strange. Hello, Aquino. Yeah, enormous rewind. The units move really, really slow. It's like, I'm on a trip or something. Everything is so fucking strange.
Exactly. Well said, Aquino. That's exactly what I wanted to get your attention on, Casey. Slow motion indeed. Well, yeah, this is a bit of a troll game, is it? Or what is this? This is two Scorpions in there, one Manginal, another Manginal, and another Manginal coming in. Do you think this is going to be all in? And what do you think that castle is going to be able to protect the whole base? I don't think so.
Well, the castle will protect at least the main goal. That's it. And also, I don't think it's a troll strategy from Dark. This is like a perfect unit composition to counter a lot of archers at the beginning, which is basically what Dark is or can do now. So he will be able to push with this very, very hard.
The only issue I see, well, the biggest issue I see over here for Dark is he's gonna get real surprised when he sees literally three Manginal shooting at his wall out of nowhere. And he's not prepared for this. He doesn't have fletching, he doesn't have any archer production, so he's literally unaware of what's about to come. This will be very interesting. Alright, let's see how fast he can break into the wall. Let's I'll time
first
it.
First Longbowman out to scout here, and yeah, there are Manganons coming up. And what's the reaction from Dark now? Second TC's up on the main gold, which makes a lot of sense here. He went for the monastery, which kind of surprises me, but okay. And now, where's the Longbowman going? Where are the Longbowmen actually? Yeah, there's more collection now coming up. Ooh, this could get really interesting here, and D3rp should be able to place TC's. No, did he sell the stone? He's going for one TC.
Yeah,
that's
he
it.
Sold the stone, yeah.
So a siege rush with pretty much no monks behind it, just one monk to collect some relics. Okay, two it is. And question for me is it going to work really? Defensive siege workshop coming up, and I think with one Manginal, maybe two for Dark, this push could get stopped really fast here.
Just to let you know, guys, if you're wondering, three Manginals kill that wall in about 70 seconds, game time.
Oh, today
that's,
we learned.
Yeah, that's how long you need. You just have about just a little bit over a minute to kill a wall with three Manginals.
Another forward siege workshop coming up for D3rp here, and he's going really all out aggressive, and I think that's a good choice. He knows his Imperial Age will be too weak, or at least early Imperial Age against the Britons, so why not try to go all in? And I really like this approach. The castle therefore actually placed rather well. Maybe Dark even expected D3rp to go aggressive, and the main goal should be secured by the castle. Everything else could go down the toilet.
So we will have this big showdown, and Dark will have to out micro D3rp for a little bit now. If he trades only one for one, that's not enough to stop this push.
Well, we know that Siege Workshop is gonna die very soon. But let's see the trade off here. Okay. Oh, one for now. Castle?
Yeah. Yeah. Got taken over the castle. And
two
he gets another Manganel.
So yeah, there we go. And that's why the siege push is really an all-in strategy here. There's still five Manganels for D3rp, but those numbers could go down really fast. The Longbowmen definitely need Boat Carrier, and I think Dark needs to get that. If they have 8 range, then they will be pretty, pretty strong here to defend against even the Manganels here. And
3 for 4 for Null!
It's
wow.
Insane
5
defense.
For Null. Oh lord, I'm just counting.
Now he needs to repair, and yeah, Militia coming up to repair. The forward siege workshop is up for D3rp. Manginal coming out, but this is looking really good. And is it going to be another 1 for 1 here? Still 5 Manginals, 6 Manginals left for D3rp, though he's producing non-stop, I guess. Yeah, still double Manginal production from at home. Still one coming up from the forward siege workshop. Might a few make sense to go for a stable in a few nights, but this is not going to happen, obviously. And Dark has a psychological disadvantage as he is getting pushed really, really hard, and he's killing Manganels, but there is more and more coming up. And he might need to go for the knights here, actually, because everything else might be too weak here.
one more shot.
Yeah, I think it's too late now.
Yeah, true. He needs either more double siege workshop to defend against this. He was not expecting so many mangonels, or a lot of long moment to actually be able to snipe those mangonels now. Boat cannon is done, 8 range. Siege workshop coming up on the wood line. Dark is housed on 55, and D3rp is playing this really well. Dark did not expect that siege push, and this is a game to learn from almost. Like, try to rush your opponent if you expect him to go 3 TCs and a castle. The map for Dark, of course, not too good here, wow. And D3rp is using this.
Perfect. I guess there's a bit of a lag, and I'm pretty sure D3rp is not going to be too happy about that. Otherwise, he would have traded, I think, much better. But this is really in favor of D3rp, I think. Those are the rams to kill the castle, and that's about it.
Now Dark is in a special position where you need to move all the villagers to both sides, like go for the extra golds on the map, go for the left hand side, gold and stone, build TCs, try to get your economy going still, and at the same time you want to be able to defend against the siege. But like this, long moment dying, we might see a short game here. Wow. And there it is, the first extra TC coming up on the outside. It's a little bit too close, I think D3rp can see it, and that's a problem. He should move villagers to the left inside as well. Doesn't have enough stone there though. And the ram now approaching the siege workshop. Siege workshop number 4 coming up for D3rp here. And I just wish D3rp was going for stone and build a castle, but yeah, he's going for stone actually now, 26 minutes in. Main stone being mined now. Woof.
That trade was pretty good again. He got 2 units for 1 from that mangonel. And I think he's gonna get the ram as well. So that's again 3. I think he's trading so well here, Dark. But it's just unstoppable, right? Look what's happening. It's just can't compete with a number of units, no matter how well he's trading.
Yeah, the beginning of the defense was very, very good. He basically traded 1 mangonel for 4. I think he didn't have mangonels continuously in production, and that's why he had a little hole where he couldn't challenge D3rp's mangonels any longer. And yeah, now the woodland is getting raided, and the plus of villagers is gone. In fact, D3rp is up by 12 villagers now, even though he's only on 1 TC.
Yeah, I think D3rp forgot 1 mangonel raiding right next to that gate over there where the monk is passing by. I think he just forgot about it. He's like, I don't need that extra mangonel, I guess.
Also impressive to see that D3rp finds the time to collect relics here.
Yes, absolutely.
He's got 3 already, very good play by him. And 3 siege workshops, 4 siege workshops up inside Dark Space. Looks GG almost. The castle is still up. That's maybe the thing that is making Dark not resign. Also, tournament final, obviously. But still, coming back from this will be a really, really big effort.
Whoa. Those scorpions are just bad, man. They are just so hurting this archer right now. Even they have the extra range, it's just so hard. Okay, finally there's a man here.
Okay, that mangonel on the front gate is going down, but it didn't really do a lot. And how many military units left now for D3rp? That's 12 in total, 3-4 mangonels inside. I think those longbowmen might be able to do quite some damage. What is D3rp actually doing now? Is he transitioning to something else? What's the plan for him? Second TC up? Is it a third TC? 2 TCs now for D3rp. A little bit surprised about this. I think you should go for Imperial Age now and like go for forward castle, go for trebuchets, make sure that those longbowmen are not getting reproduced, and then be done with that game. But no, not happening, and Dark for now is surviving at least. Monks moving forward, and they could go down. Actually, yes, that's 1 monk down, 2nd monk down, no conversion here. Really tough to convert longbowmen.
Well, he's trying to kill that TC as well in the corner. Ooh. Pull back.
Yeah, that's 2 more mangonels that might go down as the longbowmen just have the range. I guess Dark never had a ballistics upgrade or never had a university, which could hurt him. But the Longwoman for now doing a lot of damage, and Dark suddenly with a okay decent KD now is in the score lead. Look at this, 4k against 3k9.
Oh, this is such an interesting game, honestly. I mean, this was so just out of nowhere. You see all those Nihilos coming at you, and then.
Still waiting for D3rp now to move the villagers forward, and he's just about to do this, pulling villagers from the main goal. He wants to go for that castle now. I think he needs to. Oh, that's a very forward castle. Is this going to work?
I think if he does it, it will not work. Okay, now he's building farms there, so.
Yeah, and the TC coming up. Oh, this could get interesting. Ooh. Still.
There's a scorpion waiting at that doorstep. Look at that. Oh my god.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, that market placement for Dark on the left-hand side, it doesn't allow villagers to really pass by, at least in not in big groups. And those villagers are taking a lot of damage.
Yeah, but this could get really, really messy now, because the longbows are in position, so if Dark micros well, he can actually deny the castle, in my opinion.
It could be a
and
Dark
castle. Can see the Longbowman. Is he still going to try and build that castle? I think that's a mistake. Dark immediately needs to open the walls once he sees the castle coming up. And he needs to stop it. He could see it now. But is he going that way? Oh, Yeoman coming up in Castle
Whoa.
Age. Interesting. That's
oh
beautiful.
Boy,
and
this is a Doubt Castle incoming, guys. Oh boy.
D3rp is throwing this game. Impressive.
Not like this, my friend. Oh, come on. One shot. One way or the other. Oh.
Oh, the Mangonel is going down for sure. One volley and it's gonna be down. The castle apparently will go up. Looks like D3rp is actually sacrificing enough villagers. Nice shot here. Mangonel getting repaired. The castle is going up. Wow.
What the hell? What is this game, man? Oh, wow. I am so hyped up for this.
Alright, so Dark has to evacuate his Famico over there. But apart from that,
other
it's
side.
Probably not all that bad.
D3rp attacking on the other side. Just got a Mangonel and now is attacking the Siege Workshop with the Ram. So he's attacking from two sides now. And Dark got the middle back, more or less. But
There's scorpions waiting there as well in the bottom. And those all archers are just taking free hits. What is this game?
Yeah, that's really bad now, losing all those longbows, because they had the potential with Yeoman to kill all the Mangonels, and now there's no way to kill all the siege.
Oh my goodness. God. Oh boy.
I think this was the game-losing moment, because I really think those longbowmen would have cleaned up the Mangonels and then villagers take care of the rams, and it could have been fine.
Allowing
but
the castle.
Now without army, it looks bad.
Bad. You can never allow this castle to come up, not at this position. And now I think D3rp should take this game home safely. Also, a lot of villagers from Dark now moving back from the right-hand side to inside his base, as the TC will fall really fast. And the scorpions are left-hand side.
Guys, check the stone count on D3rp. 700. We know what that means.
Another one.
Where's the villagers? I'm not sure if you want to place that castle, but he's going for more stone, so I guess he probably wants to get out. I imagine next to the siege workshops where all the farms from Dark are would be a really nice castle placement. He doesn't need it on the right hand side because there's the 4 Mangonels and 2 Rams. So one castle inside Dark space and this is definitely over, and I think he should resign. And it doesn't look good for Dark any longer. The double population for D3rp here. And we might see a GG finally.
We see Arambais on the field now, actually.
Ooh, beautiful. It's not an Arambai rush, but one is better than none. Actually, it's two already. And a castle coming up next to the Siege Workshop, as expected.
This is such a chaotic game. I'm actually enjoying this. And this is just a massacre left and right. Those scorpions and mangoes are just killing everything. And there's a G and a G. What? Oh boy. What a
very nice
massacre.
Definitely a game for YouTube.
Exactly. You can take this. This is your game, Casey. If you want to recast this, it's yours.
Yeah, sometime after Christmas, probably. We'll try and cast this.
This is really a new meta, how to win versus Britain. Just go all in with your siege. Oh, wow. This was amazing.
Okay, this was fun. Thank you for having me, but I guess my wife is going to come home anytime soon now, and I will try to look at a stream sometimes, but I won't be able to do it continuously. So have fun, and see you around.
Thank you. Yeah. Have a great one.
Thanks for joining us.
Have a good one. Bye-bye. Oh, that was just crazy. Those scorpions. I didn't want to ruin this in the saying that Chris would really get off on this game, wouldn't he?
Yeah, those that many was scorpions. Scorpion
yeah.
Porn.
Yeah, exactly. Oh boy. Derf showing that he can seal the deal regardless what it is. It's just amazing. Alrighty. Yep.
One thing I take away from this map, I'm surprised that both players again opted into the scout fight, which most of the time is a 50-50 mm-hmm. if you can't really judge who wins, and it has huge implications about on the rest of the game. Mm-hmm. So I'm surprised they always go for it. Maybe next game we will have another one, and the guy who wins the scout fight gets a huge advantage off of it.
This was quite epic. I actually enjoyed this game more, and I was off my seat because those Mangonels was just shooting everything and the Scorpion was killing everything, and that was a kind of a throw at the moment where the castle went up, and you're absolutely right. If that castle didn't go up and he kept his longbow, this could have just turned into the other way, right? Dark could have added a stable and produce a little bit and go into the other guy's base, right? But that just went just the opposite.
Yeah, I mean, Derp wasn't really close to clicking Imperial Age. Of course, Dark cannot know this. Like, he sees his opponent plays a very, very aggressive castle, and most of the time people only do that if they are close to Imperial Age or ready to click up in order to get into a trap war and win it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, this castle was just to zone out from the gold and some farms to get even more map control, and yeah, the GG moment, in my opinion, was when the Scorpions caught the longbows off guard when they were transitioning to the other side.
Absolutely.
And Dark was left without any army.
What do you think about the Civs now? We have Celts, Mongols, and Incas left with Mayans, Byzantine, Vikings, and Spanish. Interesting. What do you think Derp would go over here? Depending on what's left out here.
Well, I think Derp in both games he kind of played it on 1TC, and I think at least Vikings is not the Sith for that, so I'm pretty sure we wouldn't see Vikings if he wants to stick to his style. Otherwise, it could also be kind of a mind game. Like, just take Vikings, think that your opponent doesn't expect this kind of Sif now, and just go for it. I think Mayans or Byzantines would be my choice now.
Right, and
I guess you can always go Byzantines if you just wanna do a siege, monk, push, regardless of enemy Sif.
Casey's saying Celts versus Byzantine. Actually, I agree with Casey Ron, and here's the reason. If he goes full in Monk Smush, like full Smush, he could take away Celts pretty hard, because Celts, yeah, they're very great in the late game with Vault Raiders can come and clean up the Monks, but with Byzantine Monks and a castle, that would be insanely hard to deal with, and sure, Inca would be the pickle here if he's picking Inca. But Byzantine is a pretty well-rounded Civ against Celts and Ethiopians as well because of their monks as well. Mongols also will have a hard time defending from your monks unless you go scouts, which is not Dark's playstyle. The only pickle here would be Inca. This is what I think as well. I think Byzantine would be a very good Civ here, what Derp could go with. I think these guys are taking a break. Oh no, they started. All right, they already started. So let's see what
break is for the week.
Yeah, I could definitely use a break. I haven't had my lunch, and you know how much I would like to 3 right now. So let's see. All right, 1 minute 30 seconds. They did their pick. I'm surprised Korean wasn't banned, especially considering Dark over here, as KC said.
Well, Korean actually is probably not the best tower rush civ for Arena, so you would probably, at least for the fuel edge, prefer something like Incas over Koreans, because the stone mining bonus, at least for Dark styles of tower rush, doesn't matter too much, because he isn't on stone anyways, so he wants to have some other long-lasting economy bonus.
Right.
Alright, so this actually could be the last game now, since we have a best of five.
If Dark doesn't pull something magical over here, with the way he's getting stomped here, this could be very well the last game. And, quite the different over here. Spanish and Inca. Did you say he may go Spanish, if I missed?
No, I thought my money was on Mayans or Byzantines. But well, definitely not a bad choice either.
Right.
Definitely suits his choice of have the option to play it with a strong unique unit out of like 1 TC. He can make Siege Monks, he can make Kongs, so he has a lot of option for heavy pushes. Mm-hmm. But I guess he can also go to the later game because Spanish isn't bad in the late game either.
Right. Though I think Inca will actually be good in the late game, simply because everything Spanish makes can be countered. Fingers are better than hand cannoners. Kayamuk will kill every other thing that can possibly exist on the map. So I do think Inca would be better, but the Castle Age is going to be extremely rough for Inca versus Conks, as you said. Let's quickly look at the map here. So let me talk about Derp's map quickly. So he does have back gold, back stone, second back stone. Second back gold, very, very decent map. One gold is outside to the far left of his base, and Gary's in front. I don't see any deer for him. Am I missing
it's
a deer?
It's below the gold.
Oh, right there. And finally, they picked the Titanic map, I think. That's really good.
I was just about to say.
Yeah,
I guess Dark didn't want to get screwed again by a bad map.
His second last map wasn't good at all, but his first map was pretty decent in my opinion, right? I think that was just the way it is. Let's talk about Dark's map. Go ahead, KingCat.
Yeah, so Dark's main gold is very secure in the back, and there's also secondary gold very close by. So gold-wise, it's looking good. His main stone is also very secure on the inside in the back, but his other stone is on the outside to the right. And there should be another gold outside. Okay, it's very far outside in to the left near the forest. So that obviously sucks for him. Yeah, the map should be fine if he wants to do a strategy, which would be towers going forward. So. Right. The resources don't matter so much.
Do you think this is gonna be a trash from Dark? He is doing the zebra very quickly.
Yeah, I don't know. I would expect he does it now, because if it doesn't work now, when like this is his last chance, and if he doesn't do it now, then it's probably too late. Like it is his strongest strategy, so why not go for it? Now he has a clean start, he has a better map, although he got a little bit unlucky with the outside, which sucks now. But yeah, I would definitely expect a trash from him.
Yeah, regardless. And as I said, the hardest part would be for... But I know how this is going to play out, for the fact that unless Derp really screws it up. He has two backstones. All he will do is, no matter how that trash goes, how effective that trash is, if he gets a castle up, you just make conks and go kill your guy. There wouldn't be a second option here. Remember I said the three civs that you don't want to trash are some special monk civs like Burmese, Spanish, or even Turks, because that's exactly what would happen like first game. You trash, no matter how good effective it is or not, And then you just die to that unique unit that you can compete with. Like, Inca cannot do anything against that. In Castle, he's like, he could either have monks, for sure, but do you think those monks will be fast enough to, like, he will be so fast enough to have those monks out? That would be the big question. If not, he would die to comms. And I hope he realizes that and doesn't trust him. Because trushing Spanish is also another issue because, well, everything is built faster by Spanish, right? So...
Yeah, but the thing with this is you never know. Like, he will, so if he trushes, he will scout on the outside, probably see a whole lot of nothing. Maybe the eagle will be able to see the berry patch, but that will be the only thing he sees.
And there's your trush. There's your trush right there. Lumen.
Yeah. But yeah, you are absolutely right. This map from Dark is insane for defending the Trush. Like, he will probably lose the berries, but he can work around it. Like, he can make some easy walls to the TC and have his whole base secured from there and just fall back into the back base.
Like, what I'm saying is, let's say he even saw one stone forward. If he doesn't see the second stone that he's 100% sure that he will really take that away, don't trust Spanish. Don't trust these civs. They will come and kill you. I think he should have learned his lesson when I remember in one of the team games he went and just YOLO trushed his opponent, and we told him don't do that. And the Spanish pocket just came and raided him and killed him. Like, really, it was over. And as we can see right now, D3rp is already in stone, and that's about it. I don't want to say this, but I think this will be a repeat of game number one over here.
Could happen, but game number one was also a game where Dark was down two villagers, which didn't allow him to do much of anything. I expect he will start his rush, and yeah, we have to see if his follow-up will be great. By the way, we have a barracks by Dark, so we will see probably a rush with archers, I guess.
Mm-hmm. That could very well be, and I think that would be the only way to do that, because he needs to do extra damage over here. He needs to do so much damage that he just makes sure that by the time that castle is coming up, he has done enough. And let's see how that works out. D3rp isn't even up yet, so he will be quite out there, spending a lot of wills, 4 wills. He's gonna wall that up. Okay. Those wills are building that wall so fast, man. Holy moly, look at that.
That little cage will definitely go up, but let's see what happens after that. The range is coming up now. Dark is on gold with 2 villagers, which will be enough for like 5 archers and fletching, maybe. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I don't know. Like, this map is very, very good for D3rp, so he will probably lose the berries, as I said, but he shouldn't lose much more off of this, because he will be in too late in time, and
if he puts his buildings there, like the market and blacksmith, on this berry side, I think he should be fine. Just chop that tree and put them over there, because the archers won't be able to reach that, right?
No, they won't.
So I think that's exactly what he should do, and just ignore the fact that he's rushing, and just buy yourself time, and he could do that. Alright, there comes the villagers, archers. Okay, house. Yeah, this is good enough, I think.
Yeah, maybe. I'm not sure. Well, I guess Spanish builders build their houses so fast.
Yeah,
so
there we go. Done.
It was fine. Also, Dark wasn't making his tower over there.
Yeah, okay.
And there's a counter tower. But that's a thing which could be good for Dark, because he can place archers in his towers, whereas D3rp has to commit with villagers, so that would be a little plus for him.
Exactly, that is a really good plus for him, and I do want to see that tower secured by a house in front, otherwise we may just have villagers break in or something shenanigans like that. Okay, not happening. Still walled in, right? I like how you wall the other top side too, so Narf can break in there and just find out that that side is already pre-walled up.
Yeah, that's he's really buying a lot of time. He's also just surrendering this tower, which is, in my opinion, the right move against archers in this tower. Like, you don't want to micro it out.
Right.
Just give it up, fall back, and secure your castle edge timing.
Yeah, he's gonna go back to food, I think, and there comes the house over there. He's gonna secure that for sure.
Okay, dark. Ah, he is actually on stone, so yeah, he's making his third tower now, which is not it's not his usual trademark tower rush, but something in between now. But he will be able to click up in a few minutes from this. But he's still investing in fletching, so he's investing a little bit more into this.
You know, if the castle is gonna be there by the time he even reaches matches that castle age time, I really don't want to know how he's gonna plan to fight conks. Monks, maybe, but they're so slow to make.
Yeah, I mean, it would be already enough for him if he manages to save his archers. Like, saving his archers, getting them to crossbow with upgrades and ballistics is a very good tool until there are too many mangonels out. Mm-hmm. But this could buy him a lot of time against monks.
Right. Here comes another wall.
Yeah, he's playing it safe, and he kind of has to, because there will be another tower, or he will just punch the palisade walls and go through it. I don't know, maybe he will be forced to place another tower at his gold, because Duck should be able to punch through, place another tower there.
Or really put a lot of houses there and just pray for the best. Oh no, there is a tower here.
Yeah, D3rp respects this possibility, invests into another tower.
Playing safe, he's playing safe here.
Yeah, very safe. Alright, D3rp will see this and should probably turn out immediately. Oh, he doesn't. Okay, he does.
He's aiming for the wills. Oh,
the villagers are blocking each other.
Ooh,
and the woman,
that woman is gonna die. Obviously, that woman has to die.
Always the woman.
Always the woman. There we go. We said it.
Yeah, she couldn't run straight. And
apparently she couldn't run straight. She couldn't walk straight. We know why. So there we go. That is gonna be another tower over there. Now
does it even go up? Okay,
good question.
Let's it go up. I wondered if one. Okay, he's two builders now. I wondered if like five villagers in a tower could be able to deny a built tower by one villager, but it won't get that far. So
he's gonna buy 100 stone. He's gonna buy, and he just did. He's gonna put a castle right there in their PC. There we go. He's gonna fry that tower, and he's gonna run out of his base and goodbye. And that castle is going up faster than a mill. Look at that speed. And now D3rp has to bail out.
Yeah, at least he should be very careful. Like, I think he really has to save these archers. Let's see. He doesn't get that one villager. Okay, castle is up, so I really think he has to evacuate his archers now. He's up to castle age. He would have time to set up the economy for getting crossbow, maybe ballistics, and defend from Kongs for a little while. But he's actually going for another tower, so he's really, really committed in this corner of the map now.
And
he won't get out from there.
That
anymore.
Tower would not do anything. Three conks will stand under that tower and blow it out of the world over here. Or a mango right there. There we go. You need some food to get those. Come on, put your villagers inside. Okay, he saw it. Whoa! Did that tower just die?
Was that another tower?
Yep, I think so, and it just disappeared. Oh.
Okay, that's big feels bad, man.
Yeah, this is second mangle.
Yeah, I think all these units and all those villagers are toast now. And yeah, from there on, the floodgates will probably open. Okay, he's running now.
Ooh, another villager down. So this is not the kind of trust you want to do, right? Where you lose wills and the other guy lose nothing. And there's one conk that's sniping villagers as well over there. Look at that. Okay, that conk is gonna die though. Or
yeah,
not?
So... looks like one villager and two archers into this commitment, and also a tower, which is also a lot of resources at this stage of the game. But he made it to Castle Age, he has a healthy amount of archers alive.
Yeah, and Monastery Covenant right up.
Yeah, so the game continues. Let's have a look at D3rp's base. He actually didn't go for another TC, so he wants to commit onto Mangonels and Kongs for a while. Which is definitely a good choice, because this combination should basically beat everything which Inca can make at this point. Except for maybe full monks. By the way, do Inca's get
I think monks will not do much here. You know why? Because until he has sanctity, monks are just gonna die to mangonels. And enough conks over there, I think conks with mangonels are a better option than archers and monks over there, just for the sake of this, because he already has the numbers and monks are gonna take a long time to mass.
Yeah, but he also just needs a few monks to redemption convert the mangonels, and
that's true.
If you can get rid of them, then the archers can do work again.
Sure, but look at the resources. We have 100 gold, and the monastery is actually not producing anything.
Yeah, and it's also exposed at the front, and could go down if D3rp wants to do it. Where is his archers, by the way?
In the tower. And there goes another villager.
And there's another troop on the left side of D3rp's base. Yep. Just missed out on an opportunity to snipe one or two wills at the town center.
Yep. Oh, don't lose those. Oh boy.
Yeah, these guys are isolated now and should go down. But let's see, maybe both players can micro this very well. And yeah, Dark actually gets away.
He got away, but that monastery is gonna go down, and then he's gonna be again the same like last game with goddamn monks, goddamn mangonel versus archers. And yeah, he's ignoring the monastery right now, he's just sending mangonel to engage and hopefully get a good shot over there.
Yeah. Dark actually went for a second TC, which, I probably don't like, because he really has to find a fast solution for this Conk Mangonel combination, and just booming it out won't make the cut. But yeah, let's see, he's falling back into his base. He is still on stone, so he can buy a little bit of time with the castle sooner or later. He has on 500 stone, so he can make one castle. But again, his base is kind of awkward again, where he can place one the castle somewhere, but the other side will still be
open. He's fast imping. Look at the town centers there. 100% idle. And he's banking up those resources to go up.
Alright.
He's gonna put a defensive castle, and that will be his building to go up as well. And but I think by then he will be dead. What are you gonna do against those three mangonels? And there comes your castle right there.
Well, if he manages to make it until Arbalest, then Arbalest does beat this combo, in my opinion, with all the upgrades. But
yeah, then he will be in a very good position, but then, D3rp probably is going to realize that too. And D3rp is, though, very behind. I think D3rp is going to go all in at this moment, like full all in.
Yeah, but yeah, I don't know, what does D3rp do to get a little bit more punch in his push? Like, the castle
Rams.
And eventually Arbalest will definitely be a problem for him.
Rams right now will do a lot. He doesn't need to kill the castle, he could just kill the other side of the base. And kill enough that he can do, but other than that, maybe knights would be a good option until the other guy is in.
Yeah. I'm also wondering. Yeah, Dark only has this one range. Like, even.
He can't produce more.
He needs some more production.
Okay, so he clicked up and. Ooh, okay, so he sees the castle. Lost one.
Yeah.
Monk.
definitely go to the other side. But yeah, if he thinks that Arbalest is a solution for him at the moment, then he definitely needs more production in his base now, because 10 Arbalest will also not make the cut.
Yeah, and there's your hole. He's just gonna kill that TC, man. Thank god that's not your MTC.
Yeah, he's good enough to not make that mistake. But yeah, let's see. Maybe he can buy a little bit of time by a little bit poking in and out of the mangonels.
If that wall dies, this is so bad. He will so go inside and kill every single thing. Okay, so there's a panic tower coming up.
Oh, is the mangonel in range?
Yes, it is.
It is.
There you go. Oh! Okay, only two died, but they hurt the other ones too, so. Okay.
Alright.
So Dark did secure that area, I like that.
Yeah, now we just realized his range at the front went down, so it's another one to get the Arbalest upgrade. But yeah, it's late now and he also didn't get the numbers.
You have two TCs from D3rp as well, and D3rp isn't too far from clicking up as well. I think in the next 1 minute he should be up. After that wheelbarrow comes in, he will be able to do go up as well. With a little bit of market, he can do it.
Definitely will. So.
And he has a map control, he's picking up the relics as well, so I think he's pretty decent spot.
Yeah, so what's the plan here for Dark? He's getting handcut at the moment, Bracer, making more crossbows.
Man, those nine
did
archers...
Did he eat? Okay.
Those nine... Oh boy, okay. Those nine archers are gonna do jack against those conks, even if they're arbalest. He needs like 20 of them, because those mangonels are just gonna keep messing him up.
Yeah, even the Castle Age Kongs won't give a damn anymore and just run those few numbers over sooner or later.
Yeah, you just get bloodlines and then do your second armor up. Oh, he's doing it right now and then, yeah. Good luck. Oh, what are you doing, man? What in the god's name is he doing that? Both of them.
Well, he's playing a dangerous game, but I guess Dark has to take some risks now, but yeah. D3rp's falling back, he can repair those mangonels, which he definitely should, because they are always a threat, even Arbalest.
Exactly. But the resources we are looking for, like, he's gonna struggle to even get Arb now. Why is he getting chemistry? What the hell? Why do you need chemistry for this? Get Arbalest first. I'm not gonna have bombard cannons, I don't understand what's the use of chemistry at this point. That made no sense.
Yeah, probably a little bit wrong of a prioritization. Yeah. But he's getting both now, so he will have the basically fully upgraded Arbalest soon
did
at his disposal.
Let me check, did he get ballistics? I don't think so.
Yeah, I think so either.
No, he does not. I would say he should have gotten ballistics over chemistry at this point.
Yeah, I mean his eco is set up to definitely do that if he wanted. He will probably do it after chemistry.
Right.
So yeah, he can get himself a little bit of breathing room, but what's the longer term plan now? Maybe he will just get caught out now by the conks.
Those conks will kill everything. One. Yep. Say goodbye to your army over there. Oh boy! Not like this, man. Not like this. Come on.
Yeah, but it's tough. There are no good decisions to make.
This is why I say do not trust. Do not trust conks, man. Just you die to conks in Castle Age. Like, even if he's Imperial Age, he's gonna die. And there you go. Bloodlines. Fully upgraded conks here, and then they're gonna give a shit about Arbalest, you know, with those mangonels behind.
Yeah. But well, you can also say that D3rp again had a very good map to defend this kind of strategy. If D3rp, for example, had the kind of map Dark had in the second game,
it would be very
then,
tough. Very tough.
Yeah. I mean, of course, you're always a little bit gambling when you go for a tower rush in this kind of situation, and probably even gambling even more against Sif because of all the scenarios which will play out after castles are in play. But yeah.
By the way, I like Derp's choice of second castle. He really went and secured that gold over there. So he has all the gold in the world for him, like literally all of it. Mm-hmm. He has his back gold, his second back gold, now he has his third gold, and he's having Conk standing outside the Dark's gold outside, so that's pretty good. And Dark is just gonna starve with that one gold pile that he has in his base, and I think, oh no, he has two actually. Dark has a good base over here too, he has, I didn't see the second one, alright, never mind. But,
yeah.
Okay, Rams over there. I think just Rams.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I guess in this situation, Siege Ram is like the best option because, you just run over and Eagles or Kamayuks would be dealt with by the Kongs, so there shouldn't be really an answer to those Rams.
Yeah, King Meyer was a bit surprised. He's saying Dark also won Ovanka. Yes, he did. Ovanka won one game, right? Was it 3-1?
I heard so. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, was one game where Dark didn't rush and he lost that game. At least that's what I was told.
Yeah. Okay, so we have 36 Conqueror, 14 Arbalest, and these have pretty much all upgrades for Castle Age, and once I think they're Imperial Age, they will get the extra armor and maybe Elite, and then this will be really good. There you go, Rams, more Rams. Where is the grinder and Oko when we need them?
Well, maybe next tournament.
Yes, more Rams, man.
Yeah, but D3rp is definitely hearing you going for the Rams.
He's gonna get a Siege Rams very soon. Look at his food count, 700, 800, buying it 900.
Yeah, he started the upgrade. Onager! No, he cancelled it and gets Onager first.
Hey, yeah. Not fair. That's hey, that's not good. We need to see more Rams here.
Yeah, well, I guess he made those Rams, so he will definitely do them later. But for now, he's thinking about another fight. He's jumping the Arbalest, and I guess the numbers are big enough.
I don't think they need Onager here, my man. After this fight over here.
Yeah.
I just got Siege Rams and eaten his base up. I think there's nothing you can do. But sure, Onagers will give him that extra safety for engagement.
Yeah, I mean, he's so far ahead, he can just do both, like upgrade his three Manganets to Onagers and still get Capt Ram behind that. So he's playing it safe in that kind of sense.
But Capt Ram is there, yes, and
the resources for Siege Ram are also there.
Come on, my man.
Click it right now.
I want to see it. Doing an
he's going full Onager.
Yeah.
Alright.
Where did he spend that Oh, no, Siege Ram. There, it's coming. From the back of the last Siege Workshop in the back of the base.
Oh yeah, he had another one.
Yeah. Those are a good amount of Kaya moves, but yeah. You need a bit more than that to kill those Kongs.
Yeah, but yeah, this is probably, I don't know, you have to basically fight now because he's kind of trapped in your base now, and if you ever find a good fight, it's probably now where he can't run away again and kite you. But yeah, he doesn't go for it. And also realizes it, moves out, and waits for the rest of his army.
So trapped coming in, and remember, D3rp is sitting on 4 relics as well. He didn't pick up the last one, he didn't scout it, but he will right now with that house that he's building. So he will have access to all 5, and there comes Rams, more Rams then. There you go.
Yeah.
Rams here, boys!
There's no stopping.
Rams, Kongs, Onager, Trebs, and a Scorpion. Why not, man?
Yeah, so Duck's getting infantry armor and block printing?
Yeah.
Does he have redemption already?
I don't think so. And I don't think it matters because all of that is gonna go down.
Sure, but I guess there's a word. No, he's getting redemption. I guess there's a word where he manages to convert like two honor just and gets an instant shot into the conks and suddenly everything dies.
Or the arbalest die but... like that. Or that. Is
yeah.
that what you meant? Okay. That's what you meant, but for the other way around. And GG called. Oh man, this was quite a dominating game in my opinion. This was really
Yeah, and it's over, isn't it? Well, is it best of five, best of seven?
This is over. This is for sure over. It's best
this
of five.
This is over, so... D3rp actually takes the tournament very convincing
hi.
In the final.
Hello. Hello! Hi. Well played.
Hello.
Welcome.
Hi.
All right. Yeah, congratulations, D3rp, for winning the tournament in
thanks,
a very,
thanks.
Very convincing final. Like, I think this was the most dominant series I've seen in this tournament. And yeah, also...
Well, it's a bit extreme, I'd say, but it went pretty well. I felt pretty good today. Yeah.
But also, congratulations to D3rp for taking the second place. I think you had some rough maps today, and also were not lucky that the maps of D3rp were not really trashable today.
Yeah, my maps are definitely defendable today, so it was really nice.
All right, my one question, just one big fat question. When you saw he has like I don't know, 15 longbow, and you're like,
yeah,
I'll make a castle right there with just one mangonel behind. What was your brain telling you? Do it? Don't do it? What the hell? This game could change. I could throw away 30 wills over here. But you still went
in. I was sending scorpions behind it. I felt pretty okay. I actually wanted him to commit because eco-wise, I was fucked anyway that game. I just needed to kill army. So if he commits to that and I kill 30 longbows and he kills 20 of my vills, I'm like, sure. Then I just can kill all your eco that's left. So it actually went great, I think.
You do realize at that time you had 65 vills and he had 40, right?
No.
This is why realize. From our perspective we were like, what is this road to 40 wills, both of you, what is this? And then that was such a cringe castle right there, but then you got it up and it actually worked exactly the way you said. Killed his army, and then while you were doing this you actually went and cleaned up the other side as well. So really well planned out. Amazing.
Thanks.
All right, go ahead, Kinkat, with your questions.
Yeah, I have a question for D3rp, especially what happened in the first seconds of the first game. We heard a villager dying right at the start of the game.
What? What?
thanks God I not deleted my TC, man.
Oh, man.
Yeah, well, yeah, we all thought it was kind of a sound bug, and we suddenly realized there was a dead body under the TC, and he also had to get loom, so he was basically trashing you with two villagers down, and that's probably why the game was anticlimactic.
Yeah, because I knew that rush, like I saw it before, so I was like sort of prepared for it, but yeah, I thought he would be way more aggressive, but yeah, I guess his eco was just too bad because it two fills down.
Yeah, and then loom immediately, that really spiraled out. And we were looking at the spectator overlay, there was like zero KD, and I think that's why, because if you delete it, it doesn't register it, right? Because that's what you choose to do it yourself. So that's why we had 0-0, but then, yeah, all right, man, the way to go to delete your own goddamn village.
But D3rp, you normally do this without loom, right, at rush? Or not?
Yes.
Yeah, because I was actually planning on rushing you down. I saw it last time. I was like, I'm just going to rush that down.
That's not working, man.
No loom. I'm just going to kill it.
D3rp, you didn't learn that from Denise, by the way, right? Because that's what he does. He's like, oh, I'll cast a drop of 10 bills, no loom. There you go. Bam. Oh, shit. The guy has archers. Oh, my God. Minus 10 bills right here. But, well, he learned it too. But, all right. this was a really interesting game. I think the second game was the most interesting game in the whole series, other than King Marb bashing the guy with the... Remember when we casted D3rp, Militia Rush or something like that? From God player. I think that was probably the second or first game that was pretty interesting. All right, go ahead, Kinkat. Any other questions?
Yeah, in the first two games, both of you guys opted into a scout fight very early on. Were you both confident in winning that one? And I think first game, Dark won, second game, D3rp won. Mm-hmm. So, did you guys feel like a 50-50 or did you actually know?
No, actually, both times I thought I was risking less than him. First time I had my gears outside, so if I lost my scout, it would hurt a lot, which I ended up doing anyway, but. That kind of sucked. And obviously you lose light gev, but I really wanted to steer in because I wanted to be fast because I knew that masterpiece of him was coming, right? So I wanted to be up as fast as possible. And the second one, I was I really wanted to do what I did because I think late game Burmese die to any good archer shift. So yeah, Britons were just shredded. So I had to do something YOLO. So I was like, okay. I think my Civ is worse. If I maybe kill the scout, I can surprise him a bit more than normal. It might be good. And I think I made the right call there as well.
Yeah, definitely. Like showing up with like 3 Mangonels and 3 Scorpions already is a very big number to overcome.
Yeah. We timed you, so it took about, as I said, 70 seconds. Just a little bit more than a minute. It could have been a minute because you used your Mangonel for a second later here and there. It's about a minute to kill a wall game time with 3 Mangonels. That's really fast.
It's really fast. So his map was like super wide, so there was a lot of angles to attack because I expected a castle or something, but you can't defend that even if you have a castle swap, if your map is like that, so...
Yeah,
kind of worked out. Like, if you can defend it with one castle, it would be. I would have gone maybe fast in persona, but that tends to fail against Britons pretty hard. So I was kind of lucky there, to be honest.
Yeah, no, it. You really. That was a good idea. And I think you can do this very well with your Civ, especially because I don't remember if you built, as Camille, you built any other buildings, did you?
As what Civ?
What was your Civ that you did?
Burmese.
Burmese. You have the free lumber upgrade, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's why I wanted to go.
Yeah.
Also, like the first game, I liked a lot when I was waiting for his arch to come out, then I was just camping with those Mangonels. And then he came out, and suddenly it's just such a big push. That felt great. He fell for it perfectly. I was timing that with the castle, and then I expect him to commit to that because he has plenty of army, but then there's like 4 Mangonels as well, and it's like, shit. That felt pretty good.
Yeah, we still had a little bit of hope because Dark actually managed to master a little bit of crossbows, and he was on the way to clear out the Mangonels on the right side and just ran into 2 random Scorpions of you and all his longbow died.
Yeah, Scorpions actually are so underrated. I think just having them around, they can just do so much damage. It's an amazing unit, actually. And it's cheaper than a Mangonel as well. Yeah.
D3rp, there's one person I would like you to meet for discussing about Scorpions. That would be Chris. I'll brief you on that later. He has some real fetish with the Scorpions. Yep.
Oh, man. Yep. Yeah, Scorpions are amazing.
You guys are going to have a great time.
Right. Oh, man. Okay, I've one more question for Dark. Like in the second game, in the Britons game, was your plan actually to kind of boom it out with a castle, or did you want to trash and you just didn't do it because you lost the scout fight?
I want to go castle drop and boom after this.
Okay, so your strategy didn't get interrupted too much by losing the scout. You are just wondering.
No, I just want to do this from the beginning of the game because he might monk rush and also longbows are pretty good.
Yes.
Yeah, I think it makes sense. To be honest, if his map was, if he had a back base instead of it being so wide, I would have never done this rush because then it would work perfectly fine. Like, you can micro a bit, and if it doesn't work anymore, just go back to your castle, put some stone walls down, and that's it.
Yes, I microed pretty bad.
Yeah, but it's impossible to micro against double workshop with Scorpions and Mangonels. I think, like, even Viper would die to that, I think.
Oh, yep. Or you can be dealt and just die instantly. That's also another choice. But
I think you need like a light cast switch in the back is what you needed probably. You had a lot of farms, so I think you could afford it.
No.
Oh.
He took a lot of damage.
I was trying to kill as many farms as possible, deny as much space as possible, because he didn't have much, I think.
Yeah, so but at the beginning of the push, Dark actually put on his Viper cosplay because he managed to trade like one Mangonel to four. So
yeah, that was
he stalled a lot of time.
Annoyed. My Mangonels didn't shoot, and then they walked just in the castle range as well. It's like come on, that was really annoying, and it was a bit laggy as well, so it was kind of hard to micro it properly.
Yeah. No, it Dark, you have to fix your internet over there for sure, man. We know that very well when you play a team game with them. You're like, 600 ping, 6 seconds. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Indian team bonus over there, man. Oh my god. All right. Anyways, this was amazing. Dark, really, really, I would say, well played. I mean, you made it to literally the final of this game, and obviously the prize pool is for second player as well. We will discuss that privately, how we can do the funds. I think we could use PayPal or something like that. I think that would be fine. But really well played, both of you. Obviously, Derp, we kind of had between you and Ivanka down, but then we have actually Dark here for actually making it so well all the way towards the final. Really, really congratulations to both of you.
Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks for hosting the tournament as well. This is good fun.
No worries.
Actually, a lot of good games in there as well. Yep. I was really surprised with it. It was really nice.
Any remarks, Kinkat?
No, not really. As I said, congratulations to both of you. I said you got all the way, and yeah, I had a lot of fun.
Yeah, absolutely. Me too, man.
Absolutely. So we'll discuss the team game cup that will be followed in a little bit for sure. That thing that would be interesting as well. And again, I would like to thank all the other casters, including Kinkat, of course, Chris, Casey Iron, who was nice enough to join us, as well as all the guest casters like Derp. You showed up many times. That was really amazing. And also Modri, I remember he showed up once or twice. That was pretty good. I hope we keep this going and keep this game alive. And even though DE is out there, I am pretty sure we will find a way to all play together and hopefully see you very shortly in the next few games.
Okay. Yes. I got to go, kind of. So
all right. Have a great one, guys. See ya.
Yeah, see you, man. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.